Happy New Year, everyone. Welcome back to In the Cosmos from the De Anza College Planetarium. As always, my name is Toshi Komatsu, and I'm your host and the director of the Planetarium. Now, we're trying something new with this video. We're going to start off a multi-part series all about the reason for the seasons. And most of us learn that Earth orbits the sun, and it does so in an elliptical orbit. And many of us go on to assume that that elliptical orbit is what causes the season, for the same reason that if you have something like the sun, that's a heat source. If Earth is closer to the sun, that's going to make the Earth warmer, and that's going to create summer. And if Earth is further away, it's going to get cooler, and that is going to create our winter. But it turns out that the seasonal effects are not quite explained by an elliptical orbit. Here we are looking at Earth's orbit from space. Now, the size of Earth and the sun are exaggerated here just so that we can see them. And from this perspective, the orbit definitely looks elliptical. We can go ahead and run time forward here, and we can see Earth going around and around the sun year after year after year. But if we change our perspective and we take a look at Earth from top down as it goes around the sun, we can see that Earth's orbit actually looks pretty circular. So as we watch Earth orbiting the sun here, can you tell at what point Earth is actually closer to the sun? Let's pick apart what's actually going on here. When we think of an elliptical orbit, usually we think of something like this, where the orbit is quite obviously a flattened circle. And in this case, it would make sense that there's a part of the year when Earth is closer to the sun, making it warmer, and other times of the year when Earth is going to be further away, making it cooler. But as we just saw, Earth's orbit actually looks more like this, where again, it's pretty circular. If you were to measure Earth's orbit carefully, you would find that it is actually not a perfect circle, but again, pretty close. In fact, Earth does get closer to the sun in early January. We call this perihelion, and that's when Earth is 91.4 million miles from the sun. Now, by contrast, in early July, Earth reaches what we call aphelion, and Earth then is 94.5 million miles from the sun. So that's right, Earth is actually closer to the sun during our winter when the season is cold compared to our summer when the season is hot. This is the opposite of what we would expect if being further from the sun is what causes winter. Now, at an average distance of 93 million miles from the sun, a 3% variation in distance is negligible and not enough to account for the warming or cooling of the entire planet. So again, for a lot of practical purposes, we can treat Earth's orbit as circular. So what's the real reason for the seasons? Well, you'll have to turn into part two of our series to find out. Well, that's it for this edition of In the Cosmos. If you enjoyed it and learned a little something, we'd really appreciate it if you hit the like button. And if you'd also subscribe to our channel, you can also click the little bell to get a notification every time we put out a new video, like the next part of this series. You can also check out our website and all of our links to social media. They'll be in the description below. And so until next time, we'd like to thank you all for checking in and wishing you clear and dark skies. For now, this is the De Anza College Planetarium signing off.